observe to do it, that it may be well with thee, and that you might increase mightily as the Lord God of thy fathers have promised thee in the land that floweth with milk and honey. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thine heart, with all thy soul, with all thy might. All these words which I command thee this day shall be in thine heart, and thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children, and shall talk of them when thou sittest in thine house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up, and thou shalt bind them for a sign upon thine hand, and they shall be as frontlets between thine eyes, and thou shalt write them upon the post of thy house and on thy gates. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of thy word. Amen. Amen. Thank the Lord for his word. Thank God for another year, another day, another opportunity to give God some more praise he has yet to receive. I'm glad that I can praise him. Every time you wave your hand or open your mouth and say, Lord, I thank you, you give him praise that he has yet to receive. And God is worthy to be praised. When you look in the book of Isaiah, it often talks about how it is around the throne room that the angels 24/7 constantly give God the praise and give him thanksgiving. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. A constant praise, a consistent praise, a praise that never ends nor does it cease. God, I thank you that God is God all by himself. He doesn't have any equal. Amen. He's God all by himself. We truly thank God for his favor. If I might use one word this morning, the first day, the first Sunday, and the first day of the new year, 2017, it would be straight talk for 2017, straight talk for 2017. I thank God first and foremost for my life and for being able to see a brand new day. Isn't that a good thing, beloved? Being able to see a brand new day, and God knows a brand new year. I thank him for my life. I thank him for life, health, and strength. I thank him for my family, my wife, my children, all them that are under the circle of my influence. I thank him because God has been good. He's been good. He kept me another year. I can look back and thank God for 2016 and all the precious memories and times that we experienced on last year. But again, God has given us a brand new year, a brand new opportunity to walk in his favor, to walk in the blessing of God. So I'm glad that I anticipate God doing something he hasn't done before. Amen. Isn't that a good thing?
Amen.
You gotta anticipate what God is about to do, because I'm always in a expected mode that God is about to take me somewhere, show me something that I've never seen before. Because if I trust him, the Bible says in Ephesians 3:20, but God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we ask or think. I don't care if you thought about it. I don't care if you asked about it. God said, my thoughts are even above that. So I'm looking for God to do what he has never done before, because we have a brand new year, a brand new opportunity for God to show himself mightily in your life because you put your trust. Oh, God, thank you. Put your trust. And for them that don't put their trust in, here's a time, here's an opportunity to put your trust in him. Amen. Trust in him. Glory to God. Glory to God. You want peace? You want confidence? Amen. You want encouragement? God said, listen, I've reserved an opportunity for you to get blessed and for you to be blessed in me if you put your trust in me. You know why I know that? Because God has allowed us to live another day.
Amen.
Amen. So many have gone on.
So many.
So many have left us in 2016, but God saw fit to allow you to see a brand new year. I'm glad that the word of God is still encouraging, Still, the word of God is refreshing, and whatever concerns me, I'm finding out as I grow as a believer and as I get to know the Lord more, that what concerns me concerns God.
Yes, yes.
What concerns me concerns God. So there's nothing too small, nor is there anything too great that God is not concerned about. And for this reason, the Apostle Paul was talking to the church at Thessalonica and told him, he said, in everything, give thanks. He said, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. And that can be found in 1 Thessalonians 5 and 18. So God says, if it concerns you, it concerns me. So give thanks, because listen, I've got you on my mind. I'm concerned about you. So he said, give thanks in everything. Give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. And understand this, if you put your trust in him, God will not disappoint you.
Amen, amen.
Amen, amen. I'm a witness, beloved. I'm a witness. I thank God for the influence of the Spirit of God, and I thank God for the wisdom that God imparts by his word, by his presence. And I thank the Lord that God's instruction continues to instruct me, because I'd be in the dark had not God turned on the light. Had not God given me insight. In the book of Psalms, it says, the entrance of thy word gives light. And God gives instruction. So as we yield to God in obedience and take God at his word, he continues to instruct us. He continues to influence. He continues to empower us. He continues to bless us, because we put our trust. Oh God, I thank you. How many know that when you were trying to do it yourself, you were at a loss, but as soon as you said, let go and let God, God began to instruct you to a place, to a level that you never would have arrived at had not God given you the wisdom to get there.
Amen.
Oh, great God that you are. God, I thank you that you do what you do for the purposes that you do it. Oh, God, I thank you. The Bible is so clear about the wisdom of God and the will of God. The Bible says in Proverbs 9:9, give instruction to a wise man. Now, I'm not saying I'm wise because I'm wise. I'm saying I'm wise because God instructs me. God gives me wisdom to live a life that is favorable and pleasing to God. That's why it's a benefit to trust God. When I trust him, he counsels me. When I trust him, he comforts me. When I trust him, he leads me. David said, lead me, Lord. He said, Lord, lead me. In the 23rd Psalm, he leadeth me. Isn't that good when God leads you? Oh, God, I thank you. In Proverbs, it says, give instruction to a wise man, and he will be yet wiser. Teach a just man, and he will increase in learning. And then the 10th verse, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the holy is understanding. Oh God, I thank you for your counsel. I thank you for your wisdom. I thank you for your instruction. You instructed me in 2016 because I put my trust in you. So God, right now I want some straight talk for 2017 by the counsel of your word, so that I can know and learn not only the knowledge of the holy, but be able to walk in your principles, in your precepts, and do what you have called me to do as a believer, as a layman, as a pastor, as a mother, as a father, whatever is your calling. God said, if you let me instruct you, he said, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of the wisdom. He said, I'll give you what you need for whatever you need. Just put your trust, glory to God, in me. You trusted me before. He said, trust me again. Ooh, glory. Lord, I thank you that I can put my trust in you. Oh, God, I thank you. God requires that we listen to him. We listen to him with intent of hearing, with intention in our ear to hear what God says. The Bible says in Psalm 78:1, give ear, O my people, to my law. Incline your ear to the words of my mouth. God says, listen to me. Listen to what I got to say. He said this, I want to give you some straight talk. He said, listen to me. 2017, he said, I got some more wisdom. I got some more word. I got some more instruction. He said, give ear to me. Woo, glory, straight talk for 2017. Listen. He said, I want to feel you. I want to know where you're at. He said, I'm giving you some instruction. Be like Jesus when he spoke and responded to the enemy when the enemy tried to cross him off because he couldn't do it, but he tried to. And Jesus said to him, man shall not live by bread alone. He said, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Ooh, you may be full in the sense of I've eaten something and no longer hungry, but the word of God will satisfy you as food could never satisfy you. The word of God will give you peace as peace could never be given except it come from God. Man shall not live by bread alone. Give ear, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth. Glory to God. Oh God, God, I thank you for straight talk. I thank you, God, that you don't mix your words. I thank you, God, that you continue to instruct me according to your will. God, I thank you. That's the difference with God and man. When God speaks something into your life, it is for the will of God in your life. Man can speak something as a compliment. Man can speak something as a criticism. But when God speaks something, it's to impart something into your life. That's why we give ear to his word and we incline to his law so that our lives can be effectively changed by the power, glory to God, of his word. God, I thank you for straight talk. Woo, not only in 2016, but in 2017, I thank you how you speak clearly. Oh, I'm like Samuel as a young boy. Lord, speak. Woo, glory. Your servant hearing. God, you keep knocking. You keep speaking. God, speak again. Your servant hearing.
Amen.
Let me incline my ear. Woo, glory, that I might hear the will of God for my life. God, I thank you. I thank you. Thank you, Lord, for the word of God that gives me the capacity in my hearing and in my heart to hear what God says. Oh God, incline my ear so I can hear what you say. Oh God, thank you. Oh glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God, for the capacity to hear. David put it in simple terms in his word concerning God talking, or God straight talk to him. David put it in simple terms when he concerned God's word. He dismissed every other voice, and David said, just obey God. Just obey God. I'm reading this out of the New English translation in Psalms 1:1. It says, listen, how blessed is the one that does not follow the advice of the wicked, or stand in the pathway with sinners, or sit in the assembly of scorners. David says, instead he finds pleasure in obeying the Lord's command. He meditates on his commands day and night. David says, listen, anything contrary to God's word, he said, just dismiss it. And only hear what God said and meditate on it likewise. Amen. David said, don't listen to the scoffers. Don't listen to the wicked. Don't stand in the pathway of sinners. He said, dismiss it all and hear God's word. Oh, God, I thank you for your word this hour. God, you're a good God. Look at our text here. I love our text. I love our text because Moses was a man of instruction. He not only gave instruction, but Moses was able, amen, to take instruction. That's the sign of a leader, is that not only you're able to lead, but you're able to listen. Amen. able to lead but not unable to listen. And a lot of times people fall and fail at that. And so once they get that in order, they find, amen, it's less difficult to do what God has called you to do, or God, or allow you to walk in the capacity to which you are in, or the responsibility you're in, when you learn that not only should I lead, but I also am required to listen. And Moses was a great man of God. God raised him up. 40 years in the house of Pharaoh, 40 years in the desert, and then God snatched him at 80 years old and said, you're going to be my leader. I'm calling you to lead. And Moses often and always would communicate to the children of Israel, because he found them in their time of weakness, in their time of strength, and in their time of wandering. He spoke to them often. And let them know what God was saying. I think today we have more of what God is saying, at least in the public's eye, or at least across the media, but yet still folks still don't hear what thus saith the Lord.
My Lord.
But Moses would speak as God spoke. He would talk as God talked with him. When Moses would go up on the mountain to receive a word from God, he'd come down immediately after it was over and begin to communicate what God said. And I'm so glad that God will give you a word in your spirit. You ain't got to worry about trying to remember it. God will put it in your spirit such that you can't forget it.
Amen.
That's the way God operates. Because oftentimes you'll get something in your head or your spirit. You don't know which one it is sometime. And then God will allow the things that really don't matter to go away, to dissolve, to be removed from you. But that stuff, that word, that promise, that inclination, that presence, God won't let you rest. God ever wake you up in the middle of the night and said, I told you what I told you. Don't forget what I say. That's the kind of God we serve. And Moses was such a man that God would communicate to him often and much for the sake of the people of God. So in our first five verses here, Deuteronomy 6 and 1, God is communicating to the children of Israel, and he often reminds them of what it was to be obedient. He reminds them basically of what he said. It was basically straight talk from God to Moses, and then from Moses to the people, to let them know that God still remained the same. How many know God don't change?
Amen.
How many know that God remains the same?
Amen.
How many know that God is the same yesterday, today, and forever? Don't let nobody fool you. God's word is still right.
Amen.
Woo, glory. Not wrong like the world says, but God's word is still right. It's still straight talk. It's still shot from the hip. It's still the truth of God's word, and it still can save and heal if you believe it.
Amen. Amen.
Doesn't change. Doesn't change. Doesn't change. So Moses would communicate, and if you look through the first five books, amen, of the Bible, and constantly see where God communicated his word, whether he did by word or by precept, by command or by statute, God would continually communicate the truth of who he was, so they would know objectively that God meant what he said.
Amen.
Woo! Glory. He told them, listen, these are the commandments God said, and this is from the word of Moses, said that you get ready to go to possess the land. He said, continue to fear God, keep his statutes and commandments. He said, continue to communicate this word to your sons and your grandsons. He said, observe to do what I told you. Don't forget what I told you. That's why it's so important to meditate upon God's word, so that we can remember without losing sight of what's important and what's valuable, and that is keeping God's word.
Amen.
Loving God above our own selves. And then he kind of lined it down. He said, first and foremost, he said, if I'm going to take you into your blessing, if I'm going to take you into the land that I promised you. How many know God still has promises out there?
Yes.
How many know that God has promised you things for 2016 as well as 2017? How many know that God said, listen, if I'm going to take you into your blessing, if I'm going to move you into your place, if I'm going to do a shift in your life, he said, you got to love me. You got to love me. You got to love me. And your love is proven by your obedience and by you giving ear to my word.
Amen.
Woo, glory. Mm-hmm. Straight talk. This is it. This is it for 2017. No magic. No, nothing special other than the fact that we ought to love God.
Amen.
And keep his commandments. Jesus said the same thing in the 15th chapter of St. John. All throughout the Gospels. Love God and keep his commandments. So Moses is continually reminding them that if God is about to take you into the blessing, he said, love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, soul, mind, and strength. Straight talk for 2017. Oh, glory, 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 glory. He said, listen, he said, understand my commandments, understand my instruction, observe my observances, remember godly fear, but as significant as all these things are and necessary, the greatest thing that trumps all of them, I hate to use that word, but I did, trumps all of them is the love of God.
Amen.
Is the love of God. So understand this. If we keep his commandments, you gotta still love God. Glory to God. If we follow his instructions, we got to still love God. Our boast can't be in the instruction. His instruction. If we observe his word, the bottom line is we still have to love God. Love God. Love God. Woo, glory. Look back at our text here, Deuteronomy 6:6. And then he begins to communicate. He said, I'm going to put all these things in your heart. He said, teach your children, teach your children's children. He said, bind them about your hand, bind them about your head. Let them be a part of your character. Let them be a part of your covering. Let men, women, boys, and girls know that you love me by how you walk, how you talk, how you sit, how you stand. But above all things, remember to love God.
Amen.
Great talk for 2017. Love God. I keep his commandments, but love God. I observe his will. I observe his word, but love God. I do this, I do that, but love God. That's the bottom line. Love God. And the Bible says if you love him, you'll keep his commandments.
Yes.
Love God. Take him at his word. Glory to God. Do what he says. He said, bind it not only on your hands and on your head. He said, but put it on your doorposts. Put it on your gates. Let folk know that we believe over here we love God.
Amen.
There was no secret that when the children of Israel were in Egypt and God sent, allowed the death angel to go through, and he told them in Goshen, he said, put the blood on the lintels and on the doorposts because that represented the entrance into their place. And the entrance into your space, has the blood been applied to your door? Does folk know that you are a believer? If they don't know, you need to let them know because you ought to let folk know you love God.
Amen, amen.
Them that don't believe God and are walking in heresy don't have a problem seeking to influence you by their philosophy. But we don't follow a philosophy. We follow a prince. We follow a king. We follow the living God who yet lives and abides forever. He lives on the inside and yet dwells in heaven. He speaks his word to us and through us, and we are changed by the power of his word. He's not dead. He's alive. He rose of his own. Oh, glory. He rose of his own accord on the third day. Got up out of the grave. No grave could hold him. So I'm not following, glory to God, a man. I'm not following a woman. I'm not following a person, a humanity that is unable to do for me what only God can do for me. I'm following God. So therefore, I let folk know that I'm following the I am that I am. the Elohim, the God that, glory, always existed, came from, glory, always was, went on to always will be. And God is God, and beside him, oh God, I thank you. There's nobody like him.
Nobody.
Nobody like him. Straight talk for 2017. I love God. Not ashamed of it. My boast is in the Lord. Yeah, I got blood on my lintels. I got blood on my doorposts. I got blood on my house because I love God. I know I keep his commandments. I know I trust him. I know I try to do his will. I know I seek after his word. But the bottom line is I love God.
Yes, yes.
That's the bottom line. Oh, glory. You may struggle with my obedience. You may struggle with my conversation. But you'll never have to struggle whether or not I, glory,
love God.
Love God. Straight talk for 2017. Love God. Love God. Glory to God. Look at this now. I love this. I love this. Ooh, glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Love God. God is a good God. In the time of trouble, God is our hiding place. In the time of trouble, God will lift us up. Do you remember Jehoshaphat when he was overwhelmed and outnumbered by the enemy that would come in and kill, not only kill them, but destroy them? And they were heathens, and they were nations that had joined together to crush the people of God. And that's where we live today in our society. Folk have joined together to crush the people of God. And Jehoshaphat went to God and prayed and asked God to help him. He set up a fast, and God told him, Jehoshaphat, you don't need to fight in this battle. He said, the battle is not yours, but the battle belongs to God. And as I was meditating over that, I thought about that. And there's one scripture that caught my attention. When Jehoshaphat came out of his prayer, he came out of his consecration with God. He came out, and the Bible says in 2 Chronicles 20 and 20, he said, and they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And they went forth. Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah. Jehoshaphat, not only king, but a leader of the people, stood up and said, Judah, listen to this. And ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God. Mm-hmm. Believe in the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. Believe in his prophets, so shall ye prosper. Not only hear God, but believe his prophet. Believe the one to whom God has sent to speak a word over your life. It may be your mother or your father. It may be your pastor. But if that person is a believer and loves God, you don't know who God has sent in your life to speak a word over your life. So hear God. Hear his instrument. But the bottom line is love God.
Amen.
Love God. Love God. Love God. Glory to God. Enoch, the Bible says, walk with God. Enoch walked with God 365 years before God took him. And the Bible says in Genesis 5 and 24, and Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him. And then we go to Hebrews 11 and 5. By faith, Enoch was translated, that he should not see death, and was not found because God had translated him. For before his translation, he had this testimony that he pleased God. Straight talk for 2017 is please God, but love God. Please God,
please him,
but love God. Don't forget to love him. You say you're pleasing, don't forget to love him. Oh, God, I thank you. Bible says he walked with God and God took him. Oh, God, I thank you for the good talk, the straight talk. Abraham, the Bible says, believed God for the promise of a son.
Yes.
Romans 4:3. For what saith the scripture? Abraham believed God, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. Straight talk for 2017 is believe God, but love God. Don't forget to believe him. But God knows, don't forget to love him. Not only pleasing, but loving. Not only believing, but loving. Because God has called us to a level of faithfulness that only God can supply. Oh, God, thank you. I don't know where God's taking us. I don't know what God is about to do, but whatever it is, I sense a rumbling in my feet. I feel a shaking under the way I stand, because God is about to move as only God can move. When I looked at the miraculous and looked at how God's hand has been on this work here at New Beginnings, I thought about it. I said, only you, God, could have done it. You allowed us to survive and yet be victorious.
Amen. Amen.
So God, I anticipate the move of God because I love God.
Yes.
Ooh, God, I thank you. And you too, you can anticipate the move of God because you love God. Get yourself inside your vehicle, strap yourself in, keep your arms and legs inside, because you don't know what God is about to do. God is about to move you and shift you into favor, into blessing, but love God.
But love God.
But love God. Oh, glory to God. Joshua was the apprentice, if you will, of Moses. And God used him mightily. He followed Moses, and God was with him. The Bible says in Joshua 1:1-5, and we're almost done. Glory to God. Now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now therefore arise, go over this Jordan, thou and all this people, unto the land which I give to them, even to the children of Israel. Every place, oh God, I thank you, every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses, from the wilderness of this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea toward the going down of the sun, shall be your coast. There shall not any man, Joshua, understand this, there shall not be any man able to stand before thee all the days of thy life, as I was with Moses. So will I be with thee. I will not fail thee nor forsake thee. Oh, God, I love you. Straight talk for 2017 is that if you are following God, he will not forsake you nor fail you. But love God. Not fail you, not forsake you, but love God. When God spoke to through the Moses again out of Deuteronomy and was confirming and reaffirming the blessing of God on the people of God. See, God always confirms his word, because if you love God, God said, I love you, and basically I'll make my will known to you. God doesn't hold any secrets back from you that love God.
Amen.
So I can expect that if I knock, he'll open. If I seek, I'll find. If I ask, it shall be given. Because God's not an Indian giver. God's not one that's trying to hold back his will. God said, listen, I'm trying to pour my will into your life. So the straight talk is this. If you follow me, I won't fail you. If you follow me, I won't forsake you. But love me. But love me. God so reaffirmed his blessing to the children of Israel, Deuteronomy 28:1. And it shall come to pass, if you shall hearken diligently to the Lord God, observe his commandments, commanded this day. He said, I will set thee on high above all nations of the earth, and all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, and thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God. Straight talk for 2017 is I'm blessed. I know I'm blessed, but love God. God about to unleash some blessings on your life. God about to open doors of favor on your life. Here's the straight talk, is I'm blessed, but love God. If I please him, yet love him, but love God. If I obey his word, love God. If I do what he says, love God. The straight talk is this. God said, love me with your whole heart, soul, mind, and body. Love God. Take me at my word, but love me. Do what I say, but love me. Hear my word. Oh God, I thank you, but love me. If you shall hearken, the opportunity is yours to hearken to the word of the Lord, that we might walk in the purpose of his will, but love God. Straight talk for 2017, the bottom line is, love God.
Amen.
God bless you.